falling. So yeah, I'm just gonna jump into basically what I've been doing most every workout. I know there's those 7 different days. So just let me know if this kind of seems okay to just repeat. Basically, I've just like taken the movements that feel okay to me, and I've just been doing like all of those in the workout. So if I should be doing something different, feel free to let me know. But yeah, so just start out with the 20. I don't know if you can hear it, but I have this like clicking. Track while I was talking, but I think that this is 20. So I'm just checking my ebook. So yeah, so it says 1 minute jog in between sets. So yeah, I'm just like, normally I'll put on like a timer and do that, but like I won't do it right now. But yeah, I usually just like kind of try to jog and stuff. And yeah, I haven't really filled you in, but I have like a we're gonna take my music up. I have like a, I'll keep moving a little bit while I'm talking. I have a whiplash injury that I had, it's probably been like 6 years since I've been in that car accident, but have some ongoing issues with that. And yeah, I just like have trap tightness, and I saw a physical therapist for like over a year. That was really helpful. So now I just need to like kind of keep focusing on doing some exercises that I'm not always great about, but you know, taking it easy and all that stuff. So go ahead and do this again. I'll just go to the side too. I don't know if that matters. Yeah, I can already like feel muscles in the back of my head tightening up that shouldn't be tightening because they're trying to compensate for something else not working probably. And again, I lost track. I think I'm at like 15. Okay, that's so weird. Okay. All right. Okay. Let's see. Let's see if you can see me. And yes, these are my husband's shorts. Pregnancy body, I love it. I need to insert some like fun commentary. I can't think of anything except I'm just thinking about how I haven't seen your cat for a while. So that's to let me know if you still have your cat or not. I feel like I heard you saying something about how you adopted some dogs. So you have to give me an animal update. Alright, I lost track again. Yeah, that's a really good movement. I feel like I definitely get a lot out of that one. last time, 2 minutes jog in place between sets, followed by 30 seconds complete rest. So yeah, like I said earlier, I've been trying to follow along with the ebook, but skip movements that just like aren't working with that issue that I said I had down there. Just trying to take the rest here. I won't take like a full rest every time, I guess. Just don't want to like have these like long, this like super long video you're having to watch. Yeah, so I'm just kind of stretching right now. Okay, so the Bulgarian split squats, I haven't been doing those, but I have been kind of like holding this lunge position, and that seems like that's still activating muscles and things like that, so that's kind of what I've been doing to modify that one. Push-ups I've been doing against the wall, so I'll show you that. Just gonna grab some water quick. I'm sure you're loving that eyeball behind me. Actually, drew that, even though I'm not really an artist. Okay, I don't even know like what the best way to. You're probably getting seasick, so I'm sorry. Okay, hopefully that's good enough. Seven. So I try to like retract my shoulder blades and really like round them out at the top. Yeah, that's when I definitely noticed that wrist pressure like I was telling you about. My wrists are like, that's a really good one for my, like all my muscles back in here, like the, can't remember the name of them, they're rhomboids or what, but those two muscles that kind of like, you know, retract your shoulder blades. I need to work on those, or maybe there's three small ones back there, I can't remember, but having those do the work instead of my traps all the time. Alright, so I feel like it's a 2 minute rest. Usually, yep, 2 minutes. So I think I did like 8. I've been doing somewhere between 6 and 8 since I started. So I feel like this one I definitely need the rest. So, and this one kind of gets my heart rate up too, like we were talking about. Okay, so I'll go ahead and jump in. My chest could maybe do a couple more, but I can feel those muscles in there tightening up, so I'm gonna be done. Yeah, that's definitely something that I know you are familiar with injury, just like having to stop sometimes when your ego wants you to keep going. Okay. Alright, so then the dumbbell row, I have been doing that one also. Take a little bit more of a rest. So I'm just gonna look down the ebook a little bit more. So yeah, bird dog plank. I haven't been doing that at all. Just doesn't feel like a good position for me, belly and everything. Pull-ups. I have like a door pull-up bar, but I haven't been doing anything with that. I do have a resistance band, and there have been a couple nights where I've like hooked it up to like my closet door handle actually, and like leaned underneath it and pulled on it, so I could show you that one too. Okay, so I'll show you the dumbbell row. All right, let me see if I can. Again, I'm so sorry if you're like, I got seasick watching your video. Okay, so I just lean against my bed. Fatigue about 10, between 10 and 12 reps. So yeah, on this one I really try to like retract that shoulder blade and pull instead of just like kind of pulling. I try to really engage that shoulder blade. Just remember my physical therapist kind of encouraging me to focus on that. Okay, so it says no rest between right and left. And this was something I was kind of curious about, was like, should I try to still do like maybe a minute in between? So like no rest between right and left, but then like a minute between sets, especially since I'm not giving my opposite arm much of a rest. So that would be one question. I feel like the answer would be yes, just to kind of let it, at least, you know, with the other stuff that we're doing. All right, I'm at 12 minutes. I'm gonna try to keep going here so I don't make this really long. So I think I'm just gonna skip doing the second set on that one because I'm feeling kind of like tight already. So usually when that happens, I'll try to do something different, like not arms, and maybe come back to it. So same thing with the pull-ups. I'm gonna wait on that. Skull crushers, I've tried that a couple times laying down. I'm gonna show that to you. I'm gonna get some water too. So I'll show that to you in a second. Once my back of my neck calm down. So let's see, workout day two, body side lunge. So that one has been a little bit hard, like on that groin area, but I can do it a little bit, so I'll just show you, I guess. Hopefully you can see. Already, it's like my body's like, "Can we stop? I'm gonna pull apart." All right, so leg curls on ball I haven't been doing, but I have been doing some like glute bridges, and I'm not sure if that's on another day or not, but I'll just keep going here. So ab wheel, I have not done anything. Lateral banded clam walk, I did do that. I do have some bands, and I did that, but it was really hard on that area, so I haven't been doing that consistently. Okay, yeah, so here we go. So then day two is the glute bridge. So I've been doing that, and I've been trying to kind of like roll up. I'll show it to you, I guess. I'll just show you that one. Let's see. I'm like, what's the best way for me to do this? Brother. We're gonna get seasick again. Okay. Me and my tripod. Okay. Alright, so of just like kicking up like this, I've been like rolling my back and then engaging and then like kind of like rolling my spine back down and then tilting my pelvis forward. So I feel like that kind of does like a double action. It helps me, especially on the way down, helps like the muscles in my back and then, you know, engaging my stomach muscles too and my butt. So usually do two sets of 20. I think I'm at like 5 right now. So yeah, you'll have to tell me if you want to tell me like how many people tend to get a hold of you on a weekly basis, because I just like think about how there's like 1,000 people in the group. Giving you their updates and reaching out with questions and stuff, like how could you possibly keep up with it all? It's just crazy. And I know I've heard you say in some of your videos that you're kind of like super lazy and just like sit in front of your computer just like working all day. So in one sense I can kind of see it, but at the same time it's like, oh man, that's a lot of people. Plus you have other stuff I'm sure you're doing, so